Okay guys, Buddy's back, and I'm starting day five, the lesson for day five. So I promised you some more advanced list scraping routines, so let's get to it. So the first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to data commands. I'm going to get add list to list. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take the variable function list from text. I'm going to put it right there, and I'm going to go ahead and assign this list 01. What I'm going to put in here is a special variable. Alright, so I'm going to go up here to commands, and I'm going to go to UI, and I'm going to select UI block text. And I'm going to put in enter a list of stuff, and let's just call it my list. We're going to okay that. I'm going to reduce it because we really don't need it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a list of IP addresses that I have. So they're all unique, so that'll be okay. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my list, the variable, I'm going to take it up here to text. And then since these are delimited by a enter, I'm going to put an enter here. Okay, now we can do that, or I can do a new line. Both works. So I'm going to click OK there. And let's go ahead and bring up the debugger. And I'm going to run it. And you'll see here that my list is created. And there are all of my items. Okay, so here's what's happening. All of these IP addresses are stored in my list right there. Okay, now list from text, this is a special function that allows pure text to be arranged right here. That way you can delimit it, and so it allows the add list to list to take each item by the delimiter and puts each item in the list. Okay, so here you have each item from the list here. You'll see them right here with their number associated inside the list. Okay, so it's fairly straightforward. It's one of the easier ones. But this is the list from text. Okay, so it's sort of like scraping in a way, but just from pure text. So let me go ahead and clear this, close this, and I'm just gonna call this list from a UI block, because that's a UI block. Alright, let's create another tab, and let me go ahead and save this. You remember, if you don't save it when you go to use files or something, you're gonna have problems. So let's call this list revisited. Alright, so in this one, what we're going to do is we're going to create a set command here. We're going to add that here. And we're going to call this my var list. And in here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create some random stuff here like peanuts. I'm gonna hold my shift button down and let's see, mayo, mustard, meat, buns, pickles, let's see, potato, chips, French fries, and let's see, good old sweet tea. And I don't know how many that is. Let's see. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's 9 items. Okay. So we'll click that. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do add list to list. And if you notice, I keep using list to list because this is a list. All right. We're going to call this list 2. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a list from text again. My delimiter is going to be the enter again. And I'm going to take my var list. I'm going to put right there. So you can see that when I run this, we should have 9 items in here. There we are. Here are our 9 items in the variable myvar list. And each one of these items in the list is now an item within the list 02. Okay. So this is a second way that I'm showing you how you can use list from text. Remember, we can do it from a UI box right here. We can do it from a variable, and you could even do it from a scrape from a web page. Okay, so let's clear that, and we are going to rename this to a list from variable. All right, let's save this. And now we're going to come to a third command here. So we're going to do a add list to list again. This is going to be list 03. This time we're going to do list from file. Okay, and so we can browse to it, but we're not going to do that. We're going to use our special functions here, our special folder function. And so we're going to take application because that's where I save my file, and we're going to do a backslash, and we're going to do the first one here. This is my file I already have created. And we're going to paste it here. We're going to click OK. OK. Just so we can see it. We'll do a view debugger. And now we're going to run it. You can see it created 10 items. Now if I come down here to my file, you can see each of the items from my list is now an item within this list 03. Okay, so that is the purpose for this list from file. It's a way that we can get list that we may store from a previous bot's run, maybe how we get it into another bot. Okay, so this is pretty easy too. So let's go ahead and save this. We'll save this list from a file. And this will be our first example.